So ito yung last problem natin. So sinali ko lang to kasi nung time namin, marami yung hindi nakakuha nito. Yan. So gagawin natin for the assembly shown daw, beam AB weighs 100 pounds. It is loaded with a force P equals 200 pounds and a frictionless pulley with radius R weighs 80 pounds and is attached at the ends of the beam at point B. Yan. And then, merong inclination, ito, angle X saka Y, and the radius daw is 6 inches. Yan. So, gagawin natin, first, yung tadong hindi naka-arrange. So, hindi yung reaction sabi yung ideally first natin kunin. Mas madaling kunin kasi yung tension ng cables natin. So, di ba, the same yung ano niya, rope. So, yung tension dito must be the same sa tension dyan. So, what if ililabel ko na lang siya as T. Yan. Gawin ko yung T. Saka ito rin. But before this pala, 200 pounds yung load. Yan, P. And then, meron ding self-weight yung beam, which is 100 pounds daw. So, mag-a-act yan sa center. 100 pounds. A daw is 2 feet. And B is 3 feet. And then, X is 30 degrees. Y is 40 degrees. Yan. So, what we can do next is we can draw a line from the center of the circle up to this point. Yan, tangents kasi yan sila. So, ibig sabihin, 90 degrees pala yan. So, diba, with respect sa horizontal, yan, 30 degrees yung inclination. So, this must also be 30 degrees then. And then, since perpendicular yan, then this must be how much? Diba, 60 degrees. Yan. And then, yung radius daw, 6 inches. But, mas mabuti pag i-convert na lang natin yung inches into feet. Kasi feet lahat ng distances natin dito. So, 6 inches multiplied by, diba, 12 inches sa 1 foot. So, magka-cancel yung inches. So, 6 inches pala is 0.5 feet. Yan. So, gawin na lang natin 0.5 feet. Yan. Now, if this is 60 degrees, then, diba, we can draw a line here from the center. We can draw a vertical line. So, essentially, we can form this triangle pala with an inclination of 60 with respect sa horizontal. Now, sa kabilang side naman, ito, we can draw this line. So, perpendicular yan siya. 0.5 feet pa rin. Yan. And then, we can actually draw a horizontal line. Yan. Indefinite lang. And then, from this point, connect natin. Let's draw a vertical line. So, 40 degrees yan with respect sa horizontal. So, sulat natin. 40 degrees. Now, if this is 40, this is perpendicular man. Yan, kasi diba, vertical saka horizontal. So, perpendicular yan, this must be 50 pala. And then, since perpendicular din yan, ibig sabihin, this must be 40 degrees. Yan. So, gagawin natin, we can take moments about A to eliminate AY and AX. Kasi, hinge kasi yan, meron siyang dalawang reactions. So, para hindi natin masali sa equations natin, doon na lang tayo mag-moment. Yan. So, we have first, 200 multiplied by 2. And then, 100 multiplied by half of 5, kasi diba sa gitna yan. So, this is 2.5 feet, half of 5. Yan. Now, meron din palang weight yung pulley. Yan. 80 pounds yung frictionless pulley daw. So, meron din palang weight dito. So, 80 pounds. Yan. So, plus another 80 multiplied by 5 meters going to A. So, 80 times 5. Yan. And then, next, let's look at the tensile forces. Ito. So, pwede tayong mag-transmit para hindi haba, pero hindi naman ideal kasi the same lang naman yung geometry. So, ito na lang. I-consider na lang natin yung nandito talaga. So, first, we can resolve this into its component. So, pag t cos 30, yan yung horizontal component. So, lalagyan ko ng plus t cos 30. Yan. Horizontal component niya. It has a moment arm of 0.5 sine 60. I hope agree lang. So, 0.5 sine 60. Ano yung 0.5 sine 60? Yan yung distance na naka-yellow. Yan. Horizontal component ng T, perpendicular distance is yung naka-yellow, which is 0.5 sine 60. Kasi opposite yan sa angle natin. And then, we also have the vertical component. It will cause a counterclockwise rotation about A. So, minus yung gagamitin natin. Minus T sine 30. Yan. And then, ano yung moment arm niya? Patungo sa A. Diba, this whole distance is 5. 5, diba yan? Now, 5, dapat bawasan natin ng distance na to. So, 5 minus 0.5 cosine 60. Yan yung moment arm natin. So, medyo mahaba talaga. And then, dito naman tayo sa ilalim. The horizontal component of T causes a counterclockwise rotation about A. So, minus pala. Minus T cosine 40 para makomponent natin. And then, multiply natin by again, going to A, yung green na distance. So, 0.5 cosine 40 pala kasi ito yung ano tawag dito? Ito yung sa adjacent na side. So, 0.5 tama ba? Cos 40. 0.5 cos. Yan. Yan naka-green. And then, for the vertical component, we have T sine 40 acting upward yan. So it will also cause a counterclockwise rotation. So minus pala T sine 40, moment arm niya would be 0.5 feet sine 40, yan yung distance niyan. Bala ito. So we have to add that sa 5 feet. So 5 feet plus yung distance niyan, yan yung moment arm ng T sine 40. So 5 plus 0.5 sine 40. Yan. I hope agree lang. So we have to set this to 0. So para magkasya siya sa calculator, itong expression na to, to reduce the number of characters, i-store na lang natin sa isang variable. So 200 times 2 plus 100 times 2.5 plus 80 times 5, we have 1050. So shift store, lagay ko sa A. So recall A, and then input na natin lahat ng merong variables. So plus x cos 30, yan, times 0.5 sine 60, so 0.5 sine 60. And then minus t sine 30 multiplied by 5 minus 0.5 cos 60. And then minus x cos 40, then times 0.5 cosine 40. Then we have minus x sine 40 multiplied by 5 plus 0.5 sine 40. So set natin to 0. Solve natin yung tension. So shift solve. Yan. The tensile force pala is 183.76. And this is pounds. Yan. So, check natin if andito ba. What is the tension in the rope? Ito, 183.8. Yan. Now, next question naman is, ano daw yung reaction at B? So, para sa reaction at B, andyan man yan sa pulley. So, let's just look at the reactions sa pulley natin. So, we have the FBD sa pulley. Ano na lang? Copy na lang pala natin kasi medyo mahaba. Yan lang. So, sa B, meron tayong reactions. So, sabihin natin, BY, paano ba? Mag-overlap talaga siya. So, meron tayong BY, saka, BX. Yan. So, summation of forces along Y. Yan. Again, 30 and 40 and 30. So, summation of forces along Y, we have BY and then plus T, yung T natin, ano yun, 183.76. Store na lang natin. Shift store, lagay ko sa B. Yan. So, BY plus eto, T sine 30. Again, nakastore sa B siya. Kaya B na lang. B na lang dyan. B sine 30 then plus B sine 40 para dito. So, set natin to 0. By the way, meron pa palang 80 downward yung weight ng pulley. So, minus 80 equals 0. So, BY pala is 80, tama ba? 80 minus, common yung B, so i-join na lang natin. Gawin natin sine 30 plus sine 40. Yan. So, B, ano yan? BY pala is negative 130. Pounds pala. So, pounds. Ibig sabihin, mali yung assumption natin. This is acting downward pala. Yan. And then, summation of forces naman along X. Equate na lang natin yung force going to the left sa forces going to the right. Toward the right naman yung dalawang tensile forces yung component niya. So, plus B. I-join na lang natin yung cosine 40 saka cosine 30. Bala, cos 30 plus cos 40 para madali. And then, this is equal na agad. Kasi again, in-equate lang natin yung going to the left sa going to the right. So, B cos 30 plus cos 40, we have 299.91. Yan yung BX. So, going to the left. Yan. So, RB pala is yung resultant force would be 130 squared plus 299.91 squared. So, check natin. 130 squared plus 299.91 squared. So, 326.87. Yan. So, the resultant reaction at point B is, ano nga yun? 326.87. So, letter C pala. Yan. And then, $130 yan siya. $130. $300 yan. So, diba, ito yung reaction sa pulley itself. So, pag dito na tayo sa member AB, opposite na yung directions nila. Itong BY, diba, naka-downward siya sa na-solve natin. So, it will now be upward para sa member AB. So, i-draw na lang natin. Yan, member AB. So, meron tayong 200 pounds, then 100 pounds. Just disregard na lang yung distances kasi our equations will only involve summation of forces along Y and along X din. So, BY is now acting upward. Yan, kasi downward yung dito kasi, downward, so upward siya sa member AB. So, 130. And then, BX is now acting to the right. So, BX is, ano yan, 299.91. So, AX pala would automatically be 299.91 din. Yan. AX. Kasi yan yung yan lang yung horizontal force na nag-a-act sa beam natin. Now, how about AY? For AY naman, we can sum up forces vertical. So, we have AY minus 200 minus 100 plus 130. So, set to 0, magiging 300 minus 130. So, this is 170 pounds. So, yan. 170. Ibig sabihin pala, yung reaction at A is square root of 170 squared plus 299.91 squared. So, lagay natin. Yan, plus 299.91 squared. We have 344.74. This is pounds. Yan. So, letter B pala. 345. Yan. So, ito na yung last problem natin sa statics. But, mag-a-add pa ako sa yung mga nasa finals. But, ano na lang. Sa separate video na lang, yung sasagutan natin yung items doon. But, yung in-include ko dito sa discussions natin from part 1 to part 4, ito yung mga basics talaga. Yung mga kailangan mong malaman para ma-master mo yung concepts para you can solve any problem na you will encounter.